Here comes the most challenging part, because right now there is the Maharlika funds and the economic managers, in which you are one of the key members, have supported this. From what, from your end, why are you supportive of the Maharlika fund?
If I can give a short ano lang po, historical background, when I was, this is consistent po with what Secretary Benjoc has been telling, and actually hopefully po ayaw ko nga po sana magsalita about the Maharlika because it's Sec Ben who's ano sa po, but it's
was
fine.
Supposed to take budget, di ba, from you, the national budget, because cheap fund, di ba, buti tinanggal yun.
Oo, buti tinanggal. Hindi, hindi po. Nung nasa BSP po kami, because I joined Secretary Benjoc, no, when he was governor, during the pandemic, it was also the same time when the INA, yung Sovereign Wealth Fund po ng Indonesia, was established. It was all over the news during the time.
Okay.
And then Secretary Benjoc, no, governor then, asked us to review and then to check if the BSP can establish its own sovereign wealth fund.
Okay, okay.
Because during that time, of course, we respect po that pagkaibang governor, magkaiba po ang policy decisions,
yes,
di ba? And directives. During that time, we really have a surplus in our reserves.
Okay.
The IMF po says that we should only have at least 3 months of our reserves.
Yes.
But during Governor Jocno's time, it was 10 months.
Wow.
Alam ni Mau yan. Oo, sila yung mga nagko-cover po sa governor.
It was more,
yes po. So, sobra-sobra po. So, he said, pag-aralan nyo nga how we can go about this. So, we did our research, TWG po. We even met with, I think he mentioned this, we even met with the ADB,
yes,
with the IMF, kung okay.
Uh-huh.
Both development partners said it's okay, pero hindi po sa central bank. Kasi wala po sa mandate ng central bank.
Okay.
Yung ano. Okay. Pwede, pero you need to revise the mandate and the charter of the Banko Sentral ng Pilipinas.
Okay.
So, when we had a meeting, so siguro po the cabinet, it was also mentioned that why not create one. So, during the TWGs po, Duterte time pa po yan. So, during the TWGs po, lumabas yung INA, yung sa Indonesia po. From my end po, any measure, program, law that will help our budget po, given our limited space right now, it's a welcome news po for me, and at least for the end of the DBM po. So, yun po. Kaya we will support po the Maharlika Wealth Fund, the creation of the Wealth Fund.
So, from what's coming out from the House right now, ang sources of funds, nasa Land Bank, DBP, and may Pagcor pa yata ang
ESP, pinapa. May Pagcor, there are privatization proceeds.
Is that okay with you?
Yes, ma'am. Of course, ma'am.
Okay.
Opo.
So, but as you said, in the past, when it was first studied, there was a 10 months surplus on the GIR. But right now, we are only 3.
No po. It's 8 months na lang po yata. 8 to 9 months. Because they had to, because of the pandemic po, and then the depreciation of our...
Tapos yung mga interest rates medyo federal interest rates.
Mm.
So, as far as you see it, the economic team sees it, it's still, well, it augurs well to start it now.
Yes, ma'am. I'm not sure if I'm sobrang advanced to, but just this morning, part of our TWG was a meeting with the Milken Institute of Singapore. They will release soon a report. And then I think the report will say that the time is now. We don't have to wait for it to start and create our own sovereign wealth fund. It's not yet for public consumption, but I think it will be released soon.
But that is the Singapore what, ma'am?
Milken Institute from Singapore.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We also tapped them to help us to help us when we were working on the TWG. Mm-hmm. Kung anong klase, kasi marami po klase yung ano, sovereign wealth fund. Eh. Yeah. Yung iba po, they're using it for their pension system, yung iba po for their natural resources. Oh. Ako, I think yung atin po, it's for our development, diba? To develop and to fund our at least infrastructure projects and programs.
Ah, parang PPP.
Parang ganyan po, opo. Iba-iba pong klase yung mga models na meron.
CPLC, JPE, Chief Presidential Legal Counsel, Juan Ponce Enrile, has publicly advised the President not to be, not to align or identify himself with the Maharlika because the ultimate obligation or ultimate responsibility will be thrown at him. What's your take on that, ma'am? That's the legal point, huh? From the economic point of view.
I think po, it's a legislation, it's a proposed bill, and there's a process that they're undergoing now. I'm happy po that with the first version, ngayon po, we have already incorporated yung mga comments po ng public. And then, at least in the Congress, I know that they have more than almost 200 supporters now.
Yes.
Dahil nakinig po sila sa gusto ng taong bayan. So, I think the version that we have now that they're going to pass is a result of a consultation from the public. Siguro, let's just maybe follow the process. Galing po kasi ako sa Senado.
Yes.
So, alam ko po yung legislature, no? Yeah. So, after sa House, pupunta pa po yan sa Senado, and then there will be committee hearings, public consultations, marami pa pong mangyayari. So, let's just respect the process of legislation. And then, may bicameral committee pa po yan. So, when the right time comes po, and eventually, if the version that they pass during the bicam is really... kung ano po yung
the final version
is kasi po sinasabi nga natin even the ano it's high time to have one. So for me po is just follow the process, whatever po may result, kung ipasa po ng Kongreso, mapirmahan, we'll just implement it properly.
Pardon me for taking the devil's advocate, kasi ang nangyari sa House, naging baliktad ang process. Yung consultation took place after there were some adverse reactions. Eh ngayon, sa Senate, wala namang version. But this morning, I heard Speaker Romualdez is asking Senator Mark Villar, having a family engaged in investments, to author it at the Senate. Kasi wala pa ngayon.
Again, ma'am, galing ako sa Senado.
Yes.
Pag gumagawa kami ng bill, wala pa kaming consultation, really.
Okay.
Unless may nag-request sa amin,
na
group.
Yeah, si Speaker.
Kunyari, may nag-request sa amin na group. Kunyari, health workers. Pupunta sa amin, ma'am, baka pwede niyo po kami tulungan.
Okay.
We will propose a bill, pakiayos po. But there are also other bills na dahil, kunyari po, si Senator Angara, this is what I heard before, yung senior citizens,
yes.
He was the main author of senior citizens. Galing lang po siya sa Amerika. Pagbalik, wala pa po ako sa kanya, bata pa po ako noon, nag-aaral pa ako. But kwento lang niya sa akin to. So pagbalik niya, sinabihan niya yung legis group niya, i-file niya tong bill na to. So, i-file niyo tong bill na to. Prepare the bill. So, once they prepare, nung pagka-prepare po nila ng bill, pinirmahan, final. Pagka-file po sa Senate, may first reading. Diyan po nagsisimula ang mga consultations at saka public hearings. So, tama po yung proseso na ginawa ng ating HOR. And I know that since nga po, I gave the historical background, may mga TWGs, may mga report na po tayo, and there's a lot of literatures all over about the establishment of sovereign wealth fund. Hindi po siya rocket science, I think.
Yes, hindi nga rocket science. Pero it came to public knowledge. I'll give you the timeline. Monday, it was approved at the House panel. Kasi may first reading na, House panel. Approved agad. Dapat di ba pa-public hearing ka muna? Walang ganun. So it came out the next day, Tuesday. And on Wednesday, guest ko si Secretary Benjocno, and he traced us the origins of that. Yung sabi, ako author niyan sa BSP. Oh, yes. Tapos 2 weeks after ito, here comes the President saying, parang inako na niya, parang, kasi si Speaker Romualdez was saying, it's the President's wish that we have the Maharlika Fund. Kaya, hindi namin malaman, ano which version ba papaniwalaan namin?
It's a consolidated effort po of the executive department and the legislative department po.
business. Kasi na ultimate ano that
but ma'am, di ba nakikita naman natin democracy at work, di ba?
Yes.
O, di ba? Pagka, I mean, the first version, yung mayroon pang GSIS and
yes.
SSS, nakinig naman po yung ating mga legislators,
yes,
di ba?
Yeah.
And then they removed it. And now they're fine-tuning the bill po. And then we're looking that, ano po, at least marami na rin po yung nakukuha nating positive response with the creation of the fund.
And I'm getting assured that you, as the DBM, and coming from the Senate, you know, alam mo ang kanilang, you know where to find yung mga flaws in the laws that must be corrected right now before it can become a law. Otherwise, mag-veto yun.
Yes, ma'am. I'm sure, especially when it gets to the Senate, the economic team will be called, and then there will, I'm sure din po that the committee will be converted into a technical working group. Medyo matagal na proseso din po yan. Pagkatapos ng technical working group, you will present it again to the committee. Pagkatapos ng committee, ma'am, magkakaroon ka po ng committee report and then plenary. Mahabang proseso pa po to. Lahat ng gustong magbigay ng kanilang amendments and recommendation, dissenting opinion, positive opinion, lahat po papasok pa during the Senate deliberations. Mahaba pa.
Last question naman, Maharlika. How were you able to convince BSP Governor Medalla? Kasi siya yung unang pumiyok doon, kaya nagkagulo ng gusto doon sa Maharlika funds.
I think generally, he's okay with the creation of the Sovereign Wealth Fund. Ang alam ko po, ang hindi lang okay sa kanya, is the yung use po ng reserves. Again, dalawang governor po, magkaiba yung policy decision always and direction. When during the time of Governor Jokno, he was okay, but there's a new governor, he was not. So sabi niya, oh, we can. Ayaw niya gamitin because of course he has a mandate to consider for monetary policy decisions and all. So sabi niya, they can provide yung dividends ng BSP.